good weather for a drive, right?
Oh yeah, it's perfect. Mm. You know, the rainy season just started in Japan, but it's really sunny.
Yeah, I like it because we've got the sun, but because rainy season, we've got the clouds. Mm. So it makes the scenery a little bit more dynamic.
Oh yeah. So you know where we're going today?
Yeah, Nokogiri Yama. Mm. So Nokogiri Mountain.
One of the reasons why I decided to go there is because of the famous photo spot called Jigoku Nozoki.
Oh yeah, it's Hell's View, right?
Oh yeah.
I've seen pictures and it looks kind of terrifying. You're not afraid of heights, are you?
I am.
Yeah, actually, I remember when we went to Tokyo Tower. Uh-huh. And you didn't want to stand on the glass looking down.
Yeah, glass floor. Never even want to try.
Yeah. Well, I think this is like solid stone, so I think you should be okay.
Yeah, hope so.
But don't lean over the rail.
Oh yeah. I mean, I don't trust the technology, but I trust the power of nature.
Yeah, the earth.
Earth.
Yeah. Mother Earth will protect
you. Yeah.
Arriving at the base of the mountain, our journey to the top begins. Thankfully though, it's one of the more forgiving hiking routes in Japan. Topping off at 329.5 meters, Mt Nokogiri is actually one of the smallest mountains in the country, but what makes it unique is its almost sawtooth-like appearance, an effect caused by centuries of stone mining during the Edo period. This led to the nickname Nokogiri, meaning saw in Japanese. It has long been popular for one of its main features, a colossal 30 meter tall stone Buddha statue called Ishidaibutsu. This impressive figure is one part of the larger Nihonji temple complex. What many don't realize though is that hidden deep in the forest, on the opposite side of the mountain, is a secret world long forgotten by time. We've come here to find these ruins and take you to the top of the mountain for one of the most spectacular views in central Japan.
All right, yeah, so we've got two routes. We've got an incredibly steep looking set of stairs.
Yeah.
Or a very nice, gentle, steady path on the left here. Right. I know which one I want to take, but I'll let you make the final decision.
Hmm. You know, life is about taking challenges.
Absolutely, yeah.
It's about adventures.
I couldn't agree more.
I'm going to take this route.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
All right, good luck, mate. I'll see you at the top.
Wait.
It wasn't long until Yasu regretted his decision, though, and thankfully so, as the Shirikimichi path was the only one that would lead to our destination. Given a clue by the name, Shiriki is the Japanese word for a cartman, or someone who would carry freshly quarried stones down from the mountain.
Oh, cool. It's like some like channel carved into the stones.
Mm-hmm.
Should we go in?
Yeah, why not?
Adventure time. Oh my god.
Wow.
I've seen this, man. What? Oh my god, it's amazing.
Wow, this is unexpected.
I feel like I'm in some like ancient Aztec ruins.
Yeah.
But I'm in Japan. Mm-hmm. It's so square.
Mm.
It's amazing. Wow.
Looks like a dungeon from RPGs, yeah?
Yeah. Yeah, the boss will come out in a minute.
Mm.
If we defeat him, we'll get a new item. Yeah, look, I guess like, there's like a pond over here or something. Like,
oh yeah, let's check it out.
Yeah. Oh wow, there's a koi.
Oh really?
Tarp, yeah. Look at that.
Where? Oh.
Just like a single orange or gold. Yeah, golden.
Just
tarp.
One.
Wow.
How can she survive here?
I don't know. Maybe he's a spirit of the forest. You know. Look, he's coming
or
over.
We call it Nushi in Japan.
A Nushi?
It means something like Lord.
Ah.
Lord of this pond.
He's coming over.
Oh yeah. Quite friendly, maybe. Yeah.
Nushi of the forest.
Mm, you're liked by the Nushi.
Oh look, he's coming. He's blessing me.
Mm.
He's probably just thinking like, where's my food?
Yeah, that's it.
He's like, no food? No, yeah, we'll go away now.
Standing in front of these colossal, perfectly squared walls, you can't help but feel in awe of the effort that must have gone into creating them. And as we press on along the path, we discover an even more elaborate set of carvings, with all the stone's sharp edges impressively cut to right angles, creating an image that almost doesn't look real.
Okay, how you feeling, Yasu?
Not bad.
your soul has been revitalized.
Yeah, that's it.
By the power spot.
Retired.
The magic of these ancient ruins.
That's it. Oh, look at that. I think we're getting close to the top.
Oh yeah, wow. So, yeah, actually, yeah, the sign here, Yasu, says 200 meters.
True.
The observation deck, so.
We're close.
Let's keep pressing forward.
Oh yeah, never surrender.
Gambare! Yeah. Oh my god, look at these stairs. Why is this so steep? I feel like on the camera it doesn't really translate, but this has got to be like a 50 degree incline at least.
Oh, trust me, it gets worse here.
Oh my god, really?
Check this out.
What the hell is that?
You know, I've done rock climbing in New Zealand before.
Right, yeah.
But I just remember that experience.
This is almost vertical.
I mean, this isn't hiking anymore.
Yeah.
This is rock climbing. I mean, look at like how high each step
is. That's a good point, yeah, yeah. All right, we must be on the last stretch now, Yasu. Last 50 meters, maybe?
Let's do it.
Conquering the stairs that should more appropriately be called ladders, we finally make it to the summit of the mountain. Here you'll find an observation deck that offers an incredible view of Tokyo Bay, as well as the towns of Kyonanmachi and Hamakaneya down below. Our triumph is short-lived though, as it turns out, we haven't defeated the mountain just yet.
Whew! Alright guys, so we might have gone the wrong way, just a little bit. And by a little bit, I mean we went all the way to the top of the mountain on the wrong path. But yeah, we found the correct way now, right?
Yeah, I believe so.
So yeah, you can see the sign here for a depleted stone quarry, that's where we just came from. 50 meters, but we want to go to Nihonji,
yeah,
which is Nihon Temple. Japan Temple, it's pretty cool, right? It's only 350 meters, but it was 550 a few minutes ago, so we're getting close.
On the second attempt, it seems that we've appropriately corrected our course and managed to find our way to the hidden deity of Mt Nokogiri.
Oh my god! Wow!
This is incredible.
That's impressive.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. That was, I don't know, might be one of the biggest Buddhas I've ever seen. That's pretty.
Yeah, definitely.
Especially carved into a wall like this.
Yeah, I mean, it's much taller than the big Buddha I saw in Kamakura.
Wow. So yeah. what's the name of this one?
So I've never heard of this, but it says Hyakushaku Kanmon.
Yeah.
And what's interesting is it says Koku, Kokai, and Rikujo.
Oh, okay.
Which each means Air Force, Navy, and Army.
Ah, yeah. I know, yeah, okay.
And as a matter of fact, like I was, you know, we were kind of like wondering why we saw some members of the Self-Defense Force on the way here.
Yeah, they were doing like a training drill, right?
But that's what I thought. But again, on the left side, it says Kotsu Anzen Shugo.
Ah, yeah.
So, which means like she protects you from car accidents.
Makes
maybe
sense.
Maybe they were, you know, praying for their safety.
Possibly, yeah, when they go out on the next mission. Interesting. Very cool. Interesting. Just look at the size of that thing. Wow.
Oh, wow. I really like this stairs.
This place is incredible.
Yeah.
Can you believe we're like so close to Tokyo?
Have you seen the Ghibli movie, Laputa?
Oh, Castle in the Sky, yeah.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, this is serious Laputa vibe.
I love it.
I'm expecting like a giant robot to just come out of the
wall
or something.
Despite its appearance, the Hyakushaku Kanon was only added to this site in 1966. But even though it's only been part of the scenery here for 55 years, it's still the youngest feature of the mountain by a couple of centuries.
So, we haven't had anything to eat nor drink for the last, what, like 3-4 hours?
Probably longer.
Right? Yeah, but for some reason, you know, we're finally getting close to the Jigoku Nozoki, and I'm you know, getting excited. So I think I'm just gonna run to the goal. Cheers, Julian. Yeah! Look at this view!
Where does he find this energy? You're a beast, Yasu.
I'm just so high.
Yeah. Oh, man.
I just exceeded my limit. But look at this view.
Yeah, this is a good place to run out of energy, isn't it?
Oh, and that should be the Jigoku Nozoki, yeah?
Oh, wow, it's, yeah, it's just right there. Wow. Oh, are you ready for that drop, Yasu?
I'm not sure.
Finally made it, Yasu.
Yeah.
We made it to hell.
Yes.
Feeling okay with the height, Yasu?
Yeah, for some reason. You know, I'm usually afraid of heights, but I'm just, I guess, like too tired or too hyper that I don't feel scary. You know, I'm totally fine.
Yeah, I feel like because the rock is like really sturdy. It's not like a bridge when it's swaying. You know.
Oh, true.
Yeah, it feels super solid, right? So I feel like a lot more safe.
Right.
And this, I'm pretty impressed. This fence looks very. Very solid.
Yeah.
Usually they have this like old rotten wooden like fence.
Or ropes.
Yeah, right? Yeah, right. It's like very unassuring.
Those are the worst.
Yeah. But yeah, if you guys want to have a little view over the edge here. Oh my god. 330 meters to the bottom.
Amazing.
That makes me want to vomit.
Yeah, and I heard there's a ropeway and there's even a car park. For, you know, those who don't want to climb.
Yeah, true.
But I think it's totally worth it to, you know, climb like manually.
Yeah, I feel like unless you're physically unable to, which is completely fair, I think you should climb.
Yeah, if you
for
can.
The experience, right? Yeah,
we'd recommend
it's really
worth.
Because actually, there's so much cool stuff on the way here, right?
Yeah,
along
yeah.
the route in the forest. It was really nice scenery. So.
So we've seen the remains, Hyakushak Kanmon.
Yeah, yeah.
And this. Hell.
Yeah, and hell, yeah.
And hell.
Hell on top of the world. Yeah, so you can see the sun's pretty bright, but it's going to be dark in about 2 hours. Mm. And we still need to get down the mountain, right?
Yeah, that's it. So, you know, there's a ropeway.
Yeah,
but
we
missed it, so.
Yeah, we just heard the announcement a minute ago, right?
Yeah, it's finished. Yeah.
So, yeah, I don't want to trek down this mountain in the dark. So I think for safety's sake, we should probably get going.
Oh, yeah, we don't want to get lost in the mountain.
All right, man, let's go.
And that wraps up our adventure exploring the forgotten ruins of Mount Nokogiri. If you enjoyed this video, then please give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell notification for instant updates on new videos every single week. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time.